Please open your envelope and follow along, if you will, as I read. I, Jerrie Mock, am a wife and mother. Recently, I took a month's vacation from my husband and three children. Alone in our 11-year-old family airplane, I flew some 23,000 miles. In so doing, I became the first woman in history to fly an airplane completely around the world. Signed, Jerrie Mock.
Jerrie Mock's aviation record was big news in 1964, but there were so many headlines in the 60s that, to tell the truth, her accomplishment was soon overlooked. But 50 years later, the story of the first woman to fly solo around the world caught the attention of Phoenix Graphics, a publisher in Granville, Ohio.
The fact that she had done it, that she was the first to do it, that she was local here in our area, and so few people right here in her hometown and in the aviation community knew her story.
Flying enthusiasts themselves, graphic designer Hollinger and artist Dale Radcliff struck up a friendship with Jerrie Mock, and they became fans of Mock's book about her flight.
She was an adventurer, she had a great time, and the story itself was so well written that that drew us in.
An Ohio State engineering student who dropped out to start a family, Mock dreamed of adventure. As she began to think of an exciting flight, Mock and her husband, an advertising executive, realized no woman had yet flown solo around the world. He lined up sponsorships and media interest. Though she had just received her instrument flight rating when she took off in her Cessna 180, Mock persevered against international red tape, cultural biases against women, and malfunctioning equipment.
The fact that her compass is off 10 degrees, she reasoned it out while over the mid-Atlantic, did a correction, and then she still hit Santa Maria spot on.
Mock returned to a hero's welcome in Columbus. And then the story gradually faded. Only 1,000 copies of her book were printed. Hollinger and Radcliffe wanted to get the word out about this remarkable woman.
So initially, we reproduced the exact same book, black and white, with 5 black and white pictures. And that was going to meet that goal of making the story available for the next generation. Then we had the opportunity to meet Jerrie. We took over 800 photos of her material. And when we came back, we said, pilots want to see this material. They're going to want to see the strip charts and the weather charts and all of that. And all of those materials will make it more informative and more interesting for the layperson who's not involved in aviation and will help them understand her story even more.
We really believe in rekindling the spirit of people's imagination and their heart to go out and fly. We also think that she's an unsung hero.
We got to bring our passion for aviation and involvement in flying and learning to fly together with making beautiful books. And so that was about the best a project could get for us.
The publication of the new edition of 3-8 Charlie was the end of a journey that Hollinger and Radcliffe couldn't imagine when they first found out about Jerrie Mock. And perhaps the journey to publication took a page from the woman who inspired it.
She did an amazing thing, and she went places that women had never been and definitely opened the doors there as well.